Hello there, and welcome to drivecalc.com. Why did we design this website, and why do we offer this free service? Well, let me tell you, this website was built to provide information about how to calculate our real driving costs. Using the fuel cost calculator to find our driving costs is very limited because we are not including things like insurance, taxes, repair, maintenance, and most probably depreciation in the value of the car we drive. You will have the opportunity by filling in one form to receive a wonderful report in your profile page with charts and tables showing your real driving expenses in a meaningful way. Cost calculation covers the time starting when you purchased your car and the following 3 years, and include insurance, taxes, maintenance, depreciation, fuel tires. We have a database with fuel costs all over the world. Let's take a look at an example of what you'll get. So in the pie chart, you will find your main cost calculation elements based on average amounts from users' profiles in our database shared by their part in total expenses. So you can see here, 40.79% for fixed costs. Fuel costs, 40.39%. Other variable costs, 8.06%. This is just one example of the kind of report you will get. And this service is free. All you have to do is register here, fill in your details, and that will be stored on our database. And you can look at all the other profiles to see the real cost of your driving. So, thank you for looking. Thank you for visiting our website, drivecalc.com. And please sign up, register here, and just enter your details to receive a wonderful report. We have, if you want to look, some FAQs here. All you need to do is click on the green arrow. What are fixed costs? We have an explanation. How do we calculate the depreciation? Well, it's all here for you. Simply go ahead and look at our FAQ. Please join now, register for free, and get all the details that you need so you know exactly how much your driving is costing you. Thank you very much, and we'll see you on the inside.
Continuing with the application of expected value. So let's read again at a question on insurance policy. So in the previous video, if you have seen, we talked about how insurance companies decides a particular premium and also decides and can find what's the expected gain that they can have. Okay, so now here it's a related question. So here, what premium should the company charge to make an expected gain of $25 per policy? So let the premium be P. Let the premium they are going to charge is equal to P. Okay, P is the amount of insurance, and expected gain that the insurance company wants is $25 per policy. So what does this mean? This means if a particular policy is sold for a large number of people, a huge number of people, they're expecting to gain $25 per policy. Okay, so that's what that they're thinking of. Okay, and the insurance amount is $50,000. Okay, and the probability that a person dies of that category is 0.09. So the probability, so let's write the fact that we have, the probability of death is 0.009. This is 0.009. So this means, this implies the probability of the policyholder being alive would be 1 minus the probability that a person dies, 0.009. So let's use the calculator to be safe. So this is 1 minus 0.0009. Okay, that is it's 0.009, sorry, it's 1 minus 0.009, which is 0.991. So the probability that a person is alive is 0.991. Okay, so which are the two scenarios? So let's talk about the two scenarios. So let us make up, say this is your random variable X, and this is the probability of the random variable. So X stands for the gain. So we are interested in gain. Gain is your random variable. Okay, so there are two scenarios for the insurance company. One is, let's start with the positive, that the policyholder is alive and or the policyholder dies. There are two scenarios. One is death and the other is alive. Now, if the policyholder is alive, they would gain the premium. The gain that the insurance company have would be to get the premium. And the respective probability of that happening is 0.991. Okay? And the other situation or other scenario is the gain would be P minus 50,000, because if the person dies, the insurance company has to pay this 50,000, so the gain would be negative. So P is the premium minus 50,000, because the insurance contract starts after the person pays the premium. So they would have to pay 50,000, but they would have got the premium from the person who has died, unfortunately. And the probability for that thing to happen is 0.009. Okay, so we can say, let's write the formula. The expected value of a random variable X is sigma I from 1 to n of XI times probability of XI. So what does this mean? We have this, let me change color. The probability of the expected value is the expected value of this situation is 25. They want to gain, they have want an expected gain of $25. Okay, expected profit or gain of $25. So I can say this 25 is equal to P times 0.991, which is, this is nothing but your XI, and this is nothing but your P of XI. So this is your random variable, this is your random variable, and this is your probability of that random variable. So this is P times 0.991 plus, because it's sigma, 0.009 times the respective random variable. So I'm writing the other way around, minus 50,000. So let's do a little of algebraic manipulation. So let's expand this bracket. So this is 25 is 0.991p plus 0.009p minus, let's do 50,000 times 0.009, which is 450. So I'll say this is minus 450. I just expanded the bracket. So this, if we add, this will be nothing but 1p. Okay, so let me show you that. So this is 0.991 plus 0.009 is 1. So this is nothing but 25 is equal to p minus 450. So now adding 450 to both sides. So 25 plus 450 is equal to p. Okay, so your p is $475. So if the insurance, what does this mean? If the insurance company is charging a premium of $475 for a policy of $50,000, so let me explain that. If the premium that they are charging is $475, so let's understand the maths behind this. If the insurance company, if it's charging $475 as premium for a policy of $50,000, and if you know this fact, that the probability of a policyholder of that age group dying is 0.009, that it is, you can say with reasonable confidence that if this policy is sold for a number of people, for a large number of people, they can expect to gain $25 per policy. That's the whole example about application of expected value in calculating premiums.